Every game has text, but how do they render it on screen? Today, I'll show you how I implemented rendering text in my game engine. I'm currently using one of the simplest approaches to rendering text, using a texture atlas. A texture atlas is just an image that, in our case, contains all the characters we can render. Using a handy tool like BMFont, we can generate the texture atlas with an additional .font file, which tells us which character is where on the texture atlas. It also provides additional information for each character and the font itself, like sizes and offsets. This is really useful for positioning the text on screen. With our texture atlas and .font file ready, we can start rendering. But rendering where? We can't simply just put the characters on screen. They have to be applied to something. That's where our trusty quad comes in. Two triangles creating a rectangle is the core of UI rendering. Each character of our text becomes a quad, which will be sized and positioned based on the .font file settings, with the texture from the texture atlas applied to it. But how do we know where to put the quads? Let's imagine we have two lines. The space between those lines is our text area. The height of the space is defined by the .font file, so we know how much we need for the current font we're rendering. We also get a baseline, which is the imaginary line where the letters sit. Now, with a bit of math, we can start placing text between those lines. Let's put a point on the upper line where we want to start. We'll move this point from left to right as we write our text. Let's create another point, which is our actual rendering point, and move it down by the Y offset and height of the character. We'll be exactly at the correct position to render the character, and it will be on the imaginary baseline of the text. We just need to use the width and height from the .font file, and it looks great. Now, we can move our original point on the upper line to the right by the X advanced value and render another character. Great! Now that we know how to render text, it's time to actually render it. If we were to render each character one by one, sending each of them to the GPU, it might become very slow very quickly. In rendering, there's a thing called a draw call. It literally means telling the GPU to render something. The less draw calls we have to do, the better, since each of them has to send data from the CPU to the GPU, which naturally creates some overhead. Having too many draw calls would slow the whole rendering process significantly. Now let's imagine we have to have just one trip to the GPU for all characters to be rendered. That's what instance rendering does. It's always a trade-off. This time we're trading memory for time. We'll be sending more data, but just once. That's how it usually goes with optimization. We'll rarely find a perfect solution, so we'll have to find balance for our needs. So, how do we do instance rendering? Well, we have to prepare the data layout. In OpenGL, we do this with buffers. That's just a defined place in memory where we can store things. We can define buffer of items and how they should look like. So, we'll create an item containing data each character needs. Size, position, UV origin, and UV size, so we can cut out the character from the texture atlas. What's really restrictive is, we have to set the size of the buffer before we even render anything, so that there's enough room on the GPU to fill with text data. But that also means this is the max amount of characters we can render at once. Each time we want to render a character, instead of telling OpenGL render this, we'll tell it add this character to the text buffer. Now, this is the final result. It's funny that if you look at it, maybe you'll see the same problem old Unity versions had, with the text being a bit blurry. If we wanted to fix it, there's many different ways to make the text render more nicely. But we won't worry about it right now. So, how do we know that we actually did it correctly? Let me show you one of my favorite tools for working with graphics, RenderDoc. It hooks into our app, follows the entire rendering pipeline, and lets us look into it. Let's take a look at two different RenderDoc outputs. Both of them render the same thing, but you'll notice more draw calls in the left one. That's because on the left, we render each character, and on the right, we use instance rendering. We can even look into the draw calls to see that all the letters actually render at once. Using these amazing techniques, we can make a nice performant text rendering system. And using helpful tools, we can actually check if we did it correctly. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you want to.